Hey, you guys, let's do a Kroger, Ralph's grocery haul. It's called Ralph's here in Southern California, but technically it's Kroger. Here's a bubblegum. I'm chewing today, by the way. Big League Chew. And this ribeye steak, organic, grass-fed. Kroger has really upped their game with organic food items, let me tell you. There was a time you could hardly find anything organic in your everyday grocery store. Oh, let me talk about the coleslaw before we eat it all. Kroger has two coleslaws, the sweet and the creamy. And this is like a nice traditional coleslaw flavor. I don't know what they were thinking with the creamy coleslaw, but FYI, I'd stay with the sweet coleslaw if you want the traditional coleslaw taste. And sugar-free gelatin. Thank goodness I found sugar-free. My husband hasn't been feeling well, but he has been inhaling Jell-O whipped cream. And of course, you know, if you don't get sugar-free Jell-O, you're getting just like straight sugar water and gelatin. So hopefully he'll feel better with the sugar-free. And another pasta, Barilla pasta purchase. We were just at Smart and Final, and I purchased some baby little shells. I must be like on a carb kick. It's terrible. Then I saw these jumbo shells. Doesn't that look good? Stuff some jumbo shells with cheese. Oh my goodness. I'm excited just talking about it. I used to make this all the time years ago. This and manicotti. And oh, these little baby crackers that you put in your soup. I had forgotten about these. So I'm gonna head to. Messed up with the tuna. We do prefer the white albacore tuna in water. And I wasn't paying attention and I got the flake. I think the white albacore is a better, meatier taste. This is just too chopped up and I don't know if I'll be getting this again. I think I'll just stick with the white albacore. Best clam chowder. We've had a lot of different clam chowders. Progresso, you name it. Kroger off-brand clam chowder is the best, in my opinion. So if you're a clam chowder fanatic, you might want to give this a try. Baby corns. I'm reminded of King of Queens. Every time I see or hear of these baby corns, I remember the episode where Doug and Carrie were going to talk to Deacon and Kelly about something. They were at a restaurant, and They were at this salad bar, and Doug was stressing out. Carrie was telling him something, and he was stressing out. He said something to the effect like, "Well, hurry up and let's get this over with. I'm going to excuse myself because I've filled up my salad plate with all these baby corns," something to that effect. But it's funny. I guess you had to be there. Anyways, pinto beans. I originally had wanted black-eyed peas. They were out of it. Another organic item at Kroger Ralph's. This creamy tomato soup. Unfortunately, they didn't have like the little 8-ounce box, which is perfect for like a cup of soup. And of course, it still tastes the same in the larger box, but it just seems like you have to use it quicker, or the rest of it will go bad. And good old hydrogen peroxide. In the garage. Have these everywhere. I was just brought up that way. My mom had hydrogen peroxide everywhere. And OxyClean refill. Liquid refill. Way cheaper to get the refill than to keep buying them. Spray bottle. And fancy Kleenex for the guest bathroom. Ultra soft. I like to get nice Kleenex for the guest bathroom, although personally for the whole rest of the house, we just use the Costco. Costco has a great deal on like 30 boxes of Kleenex. Not Kleenex brand, but the Costco brand. I think maybe it's Kleenex. I'll have to check, but it's an awesome deal. Like I said, I like to have nice Kleenex for the guest bathrooms. That might have to change now that my husband has been having this little sinus condition. Maybe we need a softer Kleenex for him. I'm not sure. See how that goes. Another organic item, half and half. And our silk. We don't buy milk anymore. This is the unsweetened almond milk. Obviously the Silk brand. You need 4 cups of milk to get your daily calcium. With almond milk, you only need 2 cups to get your daily calcium. And I think my husband has some problem with milk. It seems like it causes congestion. So if you guys don't feel good after you drink milk, you might want to try this. I just found out about it on accident. And I'm also realizing that calcium is such a big deal for teeth, obviously for bones, but that's just part of the equation. I'm researching K2, vitamin K2, that without it, you have calcium issues. You can be drinking, you can be doing all the calcium things, right? But if your body is low on K2, the calcium cannot be deposited in the right parts of your body, if that makes sense. So anyways, something you can do in your free time, but I'm just learning about it just recently. Anyways, that's my little Kroger Ralph's